Each studio gets pitched several hundred stories a year, but most are rejected. Of the ones chosen, most go on to lose money. Bill Mechanic was chief of Fox Studios. In 7 years at Fox, he was responsible for an amazing run of success. His movies grossed a staggering $10 billion, but they were outnumbered by the failures.
Very, very few jobs that have as much built-in failure as being the person responsible for a slate of movies, because more movies than not don't work.
Mechanic was known for the diverse and sometimes daring films he made. One of his colleagues was enthusing about a book she just read.
First thing Tyler yells is, the first rule about Fight Club is you don't talk about Fight Club. The second rule about Fight Club, Tyler yells, is you don't talk about Fight Club. Me, I knew my dad for about 6 years, but I don't remember anything. My dad, he starts a new family in a new town about every 6 years. This isn't so much like a family as it's like he sets up a franchise. What you see at Fight Club is a generation of men raised by women. Oh, that was a line that just, that was, when I got to that in the book, I said, oh my God, this guy is on to something.
Chuck Palahniuk's uncompromising book, Fight Club, was not typical Hollywood fodder. It depicted bare-knuckle fighting for kicks, and the violence leapt off the page. But that was exactly why Fox executive Laura Ziskin liked it.
I knew that the concept of Fight Club, of boys fighting, if nothing else, that could be a movie. I wasn't quite sure what, and I must confess I didn't know exactly how to turn it into a movie. But I knew it was really powerful, compelling material with amazing ideas in it, not just a kind of wild story.
She pitched the idea to her boss, Bill Mechanic. He liked it, but knew it would irritate his employer, Rupert Murdoch, who's not known for swimming outside the mainstream. Mechanic decided to greenlight it anyway.
I thought it was a good creative decision. I thought it was a movie that had a chance to be outstanding and actually make a mark on its generation, not just be a piece of light entertainment. And so it was worth fighting for, but I also felt if we did it right, it could work commercially too.
It was controversial, but it could make sound commercial sense, and for any studio chief, that has to be the bottom line.
Most of these studios have an overhead of about $300 million a year. So they've got to make more than $300 million profit every year or they're losing money. The return on investment in Hollywood last year was something like 4 to 5%. They would have done better taking all that money and just putting it in the bank. They would have made more money by not making movies than they made by making movies.
With such financial pressures, the job of deciding which films get made is the toughest in town. Nowadays, the average cost of a big Hollywood movie, including its promotion, is nearing $100 million.
You start releasing $100 million pictures every weekend or every other weekend, every third weekend. On Saturday morning, it'll create a lot of sphincter arrest in executives when they get the results.
When he found out, Rupert Murdoch was not convinced that Fight Club was something he wanted to be associated with.
By the time he was into it, it was being made. And he had heard about it from somebody, so he was really just castigating me for making it.
What did he think you were making?
I thought I was making a perverted movie.
Bill Mechanic was riding the punches, but for how long? Back at Fox, Bill Mechanic's controversial film, Fight Club, had attracted the stars Brad Pitt and Helena Bonham Carter. As is the practice when stars work on low-budget films, they reduce their fees substantially. The rest of the cast follow suit.
It was dark and really tough-minded and you know, had to be made for a budget. You know, it was a small movie and dangerous to make and would clearly cause trouble and be controversial because of the subject matter.
But suddenly, Brad Pitt's agent came back with bad news. Pitt was not going to cut his fee. That meant no one else would either. Suddenly, a low-budget movie had tripled in price. Commercial success now hung by a thread.
Gentlemen, welcome to Fight Club. The first rule of Fight Club is you do not talk about Fight Club. The second rule of Fight Club is you do not talk about Fight Club. Third rule of Fight Club, someone yells stop, goes limp, taps out. The fight is over.
The head of Fox, Rupert Murdoch, wanted to talk to Bill Mechanic. If the film was a flop, Mechanic and Laura Ziskin knew their days at Fox would be numbered.
Seventh rule, fights will go on as long as they have to.
I knew in my tummy that it probably wasn't going to be Rupert Murdoch's favorite movie. I don't think you think about that. You know, I knew it was provocative, which was precisely why I liked it. I thought it would appeal to young people because I thought it would speak to them, and in fact it did.
Still not getting it.
It did speak to young people, but not enough of them.
Shit, I lost it.
The film only took $37 million at the U.S. box office. Murdoch showed Bill Mechanic the door.
I actually felt the antagonism that existed between Murdoch and myself was good for me in a sense, not that it was fun, but that it really made me conscious of the fact that every decision you make, you can get fired for. So every movie you make, you can get fired for. So you should only make movies you believe enough in to get fired over. You know, if you're getting fired over movies you believe in, then big deal, you move on.
Bill Mechanic wasn't out of work for long. Disney invested in his new company to develop and produce films that Mechanic believes in.
What other business can you fail so publicly, so abysmally in the winter and come back roaring success on the world stage in the summer than this business? No other business can have that kind of turnaround. You know, failure and success are so close to each other in time, and inside of each product is the potential failure and the potential success.